Welcome to the CypNest software complete tutorial. CypNest is a nesting software designed for CypCut and HypeCut sheet metal fiber laser cutting machines. It integrates an assortment of advanced functions for drawing, processing, nesting, toolpath, and analysis report generation. Once you have successfully installed and acquired a license for the software, you will be presented with the login screen. Keep in mind, if you possess a local license, you must click Cancel. After accepting local license use, the startup screen will appear. Here, you can start a nest or drawing, as well as select predefined and previous designs. On the top right, you'll be able to change both the language and unit configuration. On Machine Config, you can upload a backup of your machine's CypCut or HypeCut to upload its global parameters. Additionally, you can upload cutting parameters for each material type and thickness. Keep in mind, this configuration is only used to provide accurate time estimation and processing information for process reports. CypNest allows both drawing from scratch as well as nesting existing files. First, we'll go over the drawing functions. On this screen, you'll be able to use all of CypCut's drawing and processing features. On the left sidebar, you can find selection tools. The first will allow you to select entities. The second will allow you to move and modify figures through their vertices. And the third one will allow you to paint a drawing board, which you can also do by clicking the mouse scroll wheel button. You can also zoom in and out with the mouse scroll wheel. Selecting from right to left will select any entity within the selection box. Selecting from left to right will only select entities that are fully enclosed in the selection box. Below, you can draw entities such as points, lines, polylines, circles, arcs, and ellipses. Rectangles, polygons, and more. You can also draw text and change its font and scale. And later transform it to a figure. Divide figures through line segmentation, merge entities, center align entities, explode all merged entities into individual ones, and round square entities into fillets, chamfers, and more. Below, you can find a log for previous executed draw and system commands. On the top, you'll find an assortment of options, starting with graphic selection tools. With it, you can select entities based on criteria such as figure size, contour type, closed or open figures, shape, etc., and also invert the current selection. You can also select similar figures to select all of one type of entity. The View button also allows to change viewing options, such as displaying the sort index, travel and cutting path, features such as microjoins and start point, and more. To easily modify the size of a figure, the scale command can be used to input a new overall size. The lock button on the middle allows to unlock the aspect ratio to scale both dimensions independently. Common use sizes can also be implemented, as well as selecting the scale center or the point in which the scaling will be executed. For quick scaling, you can also select a dropdown to scale from the center by 0.5, 2, 4, 8, and more times. The interactive scaling allows to select points on a figure and manually scale it. The transform command allows to translate or move a figure, selecting a reference point and then a final point. Also, the same interactive scale option is present, along with alignment options to align multiple figures to different orientations. A horizontal, vertical, and free mirror based on a selected point is available. As well as a 90-degree clockwise or counterclockwise rotation, or a free manually set rotation. Moving on, you'll find the features or technical parameters. First is the lead technique, which will generate a cut line before the cut path of a part, helping to move the pierce damage outside of the part. Within CypNest, you can specify if you want a lead in or out, as well as its length, type, angle, position, and if you desire, having it exclusively on inner or outer contours. The inner and outer buttons allow to move leads outside or inside figures depending on the desired position. Next to the lead is the delete function, which will allow to delete selected features by clicking on them, or deleting all of one type in the selected region. With lead position, you can manually change the starting point of a figure, as well as create a custom lead by clicking outside of a figure and into it. The zero reference can be moved to any desired corner. The compensate function allows to expand or shrink inner and outer contours to offset the final dimensions of a cut part, compensating for cut width, especially on thicker materials. The ring cut option allows to create ring cut curves on vertices within an angle and minimum length threshold. You can set an extended length or size for the rings, as well as if you'd like the rings to be executed without the laser firing or within an inner or outer contour. The microjoin option allows to create small uncut gaps within a part. This is especially useful for thinner material to prevent parts from falling down or popping up and potentially causing collisions with the laser head. The reverse option allows to reverse the path direction or specify an absolute direction for the cut. The release feature allows to create corner stress reliefs for bending. The fillet feature allows to round edges with concave arcs, round fillets, chamfers, or parallel line offsets. The cooling point option allows to add cooling or delay points where the laser head will stop moving and firing for a predetermined amount of time set on the global parameters. They can be selected manually or automatically based on an angle criteria. The gap feature creates a microjoin of specified size right at the end of a cut before going back to the starting point. The gap width is specified on overcut size. You can select whether you'd like to include a gap to inner contours and or outer ones. You can also specify different figure size ranges where you'd like to set the gaps, making it possible to apply gaps to smaller parts only and leave larger ones free. Additionally, there is also the overcut function, which does essentially the same as the gap function, but instead of leaving a gap, it recuts the part from the starting point. The seal command clears the gap and overcut features on selected figures.